An object S of mass 200 grams is free to move on a track AOB lying in a vertical plane. This rail is formed of two parts. The first one, AO, is straight and horizontal, and the other one, OB, is straight and inclined by an angle alpha with respect to the horizontal, where sine alpha equals 0.1. Along AO, S moves without friction, and along OB, S is acted upon by a force of friction, F, that is assumed to be constant and parallel to the path. The object of this exercise is to determine the magnitude F of the friction force. Let's start with part A. In order to launch this object on track AO, we use a spring with constant 320 newtons per meter and natural length L0. One end of the spring is fixed at A to a support. We compress the spring by X0, we place the object next to the free end of the spring, and then we release them. When the spring attains its natural length, L0, the object leaves the spring with a speed whose magnitude is 8 meters per second. It thus slides along the horizontal part, and as it reaches O, it rises up the inclined track OB.
Number 1. Determine the value of x0. x0 can be determined using the principle of conservation of mechanical energy. Consider the system spring object Earth. Since there is no friction, or the net work done by the non-conservative forces equals zero, then the mechanical energy of this system is conserved. So ME initial equals ME final. ME initial corresponds to the position A of the object, or when the spring is compressed by the distance x0, and ME final corresponds to the position D of the object, or when the spring returns back to its natural position and the object leaves the spring with the velocity v0. So we can write KE plus GPE plus EPE at the initial position equals to that at the final position. The body starts from rest, so KE initial equals 0. HA equals HD, so the initial gravitational potential energy cancels the final gravitational potential energy. Since the spring returns back to its natural length, so the final elastic potential energy equals 0. The elastic potential energy at the initial position equals 1/2 kx0 squared, and the final kinetic energy equals 1/2 mv0 squared. Replace each physical quantity by its value, we get x0 equals 0.2 meters, which is equal to 20 centimeters.
Let's move to part 2. The object reaches O with a speed v0 whose magnitude is 8 meters per second. Justify. Remember that S leaves the spring at point D with a speed v0. Now we want to prove that S reaches point O with a speed v0. So our system is S. What are the external forces acting on S during its motion between D and O? We have the weight mg and the normal force N. But mg and N are vertical forces, so they do not contribute to the horizontal motion of S along DO. Therefore, the net force equals 0. Now, we are talking about Newton's first law. In Newton's first law, if the object is initially at rest, it remains at rest. And if it is initially in motion, it will continue in URM, or uniform rectilinear motion. Now, at point D, S was in motion. And between D and O, the net force acting on S is 0. Then S will continue in uniform rectilinear motion. Therefore, it will reach point O with a speed whose magnitude is 8 meters per second.
Part B. At O, S moves up the inclined track OB with a speed V0 at the instant T0 equals 0. A convenient apparatus is used to trace as functions of time the curves representing the kinetic energy of the object and the gravitational potential energy of the system object Earth. The horizontal plane passing through point O is taken as a gravitational potential energy reference and take G equals 10 meters per second squared.
These curves are represented in the adjacent figure between time 0 and time 4 seconds according to the scale. One division on the time axis corresponds to 1 second. One division on the energy axis corresponds to 1 joule. Number 1. Curve I represents the kinetic energy Ke of S as a function of time. Why? We know that the mass of the object is 200 grams, and at time 0, V0 equals 8 meters per second. Let's calculate the initial kinetic energy of S. The initial kinetic energy is given by this expression, 1/2 mv0 squared. Replace m by 0.2 kilograms and v0 by 8 meters per second, then the initial kinetic energy is 6.4 joules. Now, look at the two curves. Which curve starts at 6.4 joules? It is curve I. Then, curve I represents Ke as a function of time.
Focus, please. This is important.
2A. Use the curves in order to specify whether the system possesses kinetic energy or gravitational potential energy at time 4 seconds. Look at curve 1. At time 4 seconds, Ke equals 0. And at time 4 seconds, according to curve 2, the gravitational potential energy equals 3.2 joules. Therefore, the form of the energy stored in the system at time 4 second is gravitational potential energy.
Let's move to part B. Determine the maximum distance covered by the object along track OB. This is a track OB. Let's say that the object reaches the maximum altitude at point C. The maximum value of the gravitational potential energy equals mg times h max, which is the maximum altitude. In the previous slide, we have seen that the maximum value of the gravitational potential energy is 3.2 joules. Then, h max equals 3.2 over 0.2 times 10, which is equal to 1.6 meters. Now, we want to calculate the maximum distance traveled along track OB. This is the maximum distance. Look at the right-angled triangle. Sine alpha equals h max over d max. Then, OC or d max equals h max over sine alpha. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the maximum distance traveled along OB, which is equal to 16 meters.
CI. Complete the table with the values of the mechanical energy of the system at each instant. The mechanical energy equals the kinetic energy plus the gravitational potential energy. At time 0, look at the curves. According to curve 1, the kinetic energy equals 6.4 joules, and according to curve 2, the gravitational potential energy equals 0 joules. Therefore, Me0 equals 6.4 joules. At time 2 seconds, look at the curves. According to curve 1, the kinetic energy equals 1.60 joules and the gravitational potential energy according to curve 2 equals 2.4 joules. So ME2 equals 4 joules. At time 3 seconds, so the kinetic energy equals 0.4 and the gravitational potential energy equals 3. Therefore, the mechanical energy at this instant equals 3.4 joules. And similarly, at t equal 4 seconds, The mechanical energy equals 0 plus 3.2 equals 3.2 joules.
Now, examine the values of the mechanical energy at time 0, at time 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and 4 seconds. The mechanical energy decreases with time. Therefore, S is acted upon by friction. You know that the work done by the friction force results in a transformation of mechanical energy into thermal energy, thus decreasing the value of the mechanical energy. Now we want to calculate the variation in the mechanical energy of the system between time 0 and time 4 seconds. The variation in the mechanical energy equals the mechanical energy at time 4 seconds minus the initial mechanical energy. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of this variation, which is equal to minus 3.2 joules. Now we want to determine the value of F, which is the magnitude of the friction force. We know that the variation in the mechanical energy equals the net work by the non-conservative forces acting in the system. The only non-conservative force that performs work in the system is the friction force. Then we have here work done by the friction force. This work equals minus F times D max. In a previous slide, we have calculated the value of D max, which is equal to 16 meters. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the friction force, which is equal to 0.2 newtons.